Previously on TVSins.
Firemen came and broke through the chimney top, and me and Mom were expecting them to pull out a dead cat or a bird. And instead, they pulled out my father. He was dressed in a Santa Claus suit.
Captain's log, stardate 1513.1.
Logration.
Mr. Spock. Temporarily in command.
Temporarily? Even in the dialogue, you can hear William Shatner's reluctance to give any other character credence.
Ship Surgeon McCoy and myself are now beaming down to the planet's surface.
Oh, and a third guy who I'm not mentioning here because he's not a series regular and will probably die soon.
Routine, but for the fact that Nancy Crater is that one woman in Dr. McCoy's past.
I guess the captain's log is for record-keeping, pertinent scientific information, and all the ship's juicy gossip. Spill it, Kirky, baby. Let's hear all the deets. Well, I guess we know who they got to do the theme song.
Oh, this is Captain Jim Kirk of the Enterprise.
We also like to call him Captain Creepy Eyes.
It's quite warm here, isn't it?
Geez, Darnell, don't they teach some sort of the power of space boners, how to combat them on the job class at Starfleet training? F*** Darnell. Just mainline this classic opening into my soul. I said mainline it, dammit!
These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. It's 5-year mission.
Or as some people like to call it, a 3-year mission.
Captain's log. Additional entry. We were totally unaware that each member of the landing party was seeing a different Nancy Crater.
Sin, Captain's log. Additional sentry. We've discovered yet another instance of narration after landing in this episode for only 5 minutes. And its only purpose appears to be to remind us what we already saw with our own eyes just a few minutes ago before the opening theme. Since we have no way of knowing how often this will happen, we are protecting ourselves by adding on 10 sins and setting sin phasers to kill. Wait, I know the show is famous for glamour shotting the women, but is Kirk in soft focus here too? Look at the difference between the sharpness on him and Bones. I mean, you can see every nook and cranny of Kelly's deforestation, but Shatner looks like he and the camera bathed in Vaseline.
All research personnel on alien planets are required to have their health certified by Starship Surgeon at 1-year intervals.
And by God, we don't have any surgeons in Starfleet other than the man who was married to your wife.
But for a woman, you understand, of course.
That's Trekkist.
So she's a handsome woman, yes, but hardly 25.
So much to unpack here. Why is McCoy talking to a former girlfriend's husband about how hot she still is? Why is Kirk choosing to dissuade McCoy of his opinion on her looks? The 60s, when women were just talked about by men as if they were prizes to critique. Glad that no longer happens. Man, this sure is going to be awkward when Starfleet asks why I didn't mention Darnell in the captain's log. Kirk follows the standard procedure when upon seeing a corpse, making sure you reach in his or her mouth.
I was just...
Close up for drama, close up for tension, close up for emotion, close up for more drama, close up for more tension, close up for more emotion? Holy shit, is the rest of this episode just alternating close-ups?
We'll complete your examinations tomorrow.
And as far as this plant that killed my crewman that might be useful for testing, who needs it anyway, right?
Lock onto us. 3 beaming up.
But not going to let the transporter guy know that one of you will be a corpse when you materialize? No? Okay, carry on.
Suhura, your last subspace log contained an error in the frequencies column.
Leonard Part Dix would be excellent at log sense.
Why don't you tell me I'm an attractive young lady?
Because he's her commanding officer, and that would be insanely inappropriate for starters. This seems like a super convoluted way of showing us how Spock shows no emotions. Also, thirsty Uhura is thirsty.
That means that somebody is dead and you just sit there. It could be Captain Kirk.
Lieutenant, my demonstration of concern will not change what has happened.
Okay, fine, logical McLogic pants. But whether or not you have any emotion about Kirk possibly being the one who died, it's still probably a good idea for you to immediately get details, so you can start procedures if the first in command just teleported back deceased. Also, it's kind of amazing that the landing crew didn't tell the transporter room who died, and it's mostly because the show thinks Darnell is unimportant, but it's also kind of amazing that anyone thinks that if Captain Kirk died, it wouldn't have been part of the message. That is what would be known as burying the lead.
Jim, don't tell me my business. He could not have swallowed any. My instruments would have picked up any trace of it whatsoever.
Then what kills a healthy man?
Well, that escalated quickly. These two find excuses to yell at each other like a couple who can't stop looking for ways to have angry sex.
Commander Dominguez says we have supplies he urgently needs.
Tell Jose he'll get us chili peppers when we get there.
Backhanded progressiveness. Spock's blinged out AirPod may be the greatest thing ever. I'd give this show credit for predicting Bluetooth and cell phones if it weren't for the fact that displays that are just constantly changing colored rectangles still haven't quite gone mainstream.
You In the mood for an apology?
Apology for what? Bones was 2 feet from a dead crewman and should have been investigating the cause of death, but instead was talking about how beautiful his ex-girlfriend looked.
Considering the inescapable fact that you are a trespasser on my planet...
Your complaint is noted, sir.
Noted. And also bullshit, right? Your planet? You've been there for a measly 5 years as a research specialist. Who died and made you con?
We're all aware of the need for salt on a hot and arid planet like this, Professor. But it's a mystery, and I don't like mysteries.
That's for my DJ Hooker years.
Salt.
And good thing, after having a crewman die from possibly ingesting something, why would a doctor let anything on this planet touch his tongue without first an alternate investigation?
I better locate crewman Green.
Green!
Green!
So instead of actually looking for him, we are both going to stand here shouting his name for the next few minutes to try to make sure the metamorphosing salt alien has a chance to transform into it.
There's a body down there, a sturgeon. We'll bring him home, sir.
Why didn't Sturgeon come along for the ride? They have more than enough transporter platforms. Or do they need to stick dead guys in a tube of some sort so they can fit the vertical beaming scheme? They brought that dickhead Darnell up here with him last time.
Oh, Green. What went on down there?
If it's not convenient enough that it's not easy being Green here just happens to see someone in the hall he knows, no worries. She also happens to be transporting Sulu's celery snacks on a tray and decides to stop, steal one, and salt it in the hallway. Also, considering how flirty and manipulative the creature was as Nancy, it's odd that as Green, it's just creepy and trying to steal from people without saying anything. Also, salted celery. Discount 1960s Seth MacFarlane.
How about that?
Yeah, how'd you like to have her as your own personal yeoman?
This line alone is reason enough for me to never mourn a single red shirt death again. One of my favorite things about Star Trek is that all this future technology exists on the same ship with door plates that look like they're from a 1960s elementary school.
Why do people have to call inanimate objects she?
Well, Janice just called the plant a he, and you actually said it was a she, so I'm confused by this Seinfeldian aside.
In fact, I keep expecting one of these plants of yours to grab me.
A little full of ourselves, aren't we, Janice? Pet senses danger and sends a warning signal about something the humans can't see, even if this pet is an obvious hand-puppet alien flower cliché. Can the creature not think of a better place to suck the salt out of someone? Man, why can't it just ask where they keep the large pallets of salt around here? Why go through all this to lick salt? Also, if the creature's plan was just to attack and kill Uhura, then why go through the charade of changing into the man Uhura's imagining?
What's the matter, can't you sleep?
Nope.
Try taking one of those red pills you gave me last week.
Seriously, is the homoeroticism between these two supposed to be a subtext or just flat-out text? What the f*** is this that Kirk is eating? It's like Jolly Rancher made a candy called props. One thing I don't understand, the creature apparently has the power to look like whomever it wants another person to see it as. That's why it was able to look like three different people at the same time to three different guys. So why did it pick the older Nancy here, instead of the younger one McCoy was transfixed by earlier?
Nancy. Well, come in. I've been worried sick about you.
He literally just heard from Kirk that there had been zero updates on tracking down Nancy, and thinks nothing of it when she's outside his door? Are space boners that powerful? Yes, I guess they are.
I am now certain that the violent death of my crewman...
How do you know it was violent? You haven't seen any of them die. There hasn't been a sign of struggle with any of the bodies. Maybe it was a totally peaceful death by total salt depletion. McCoy apparently takes pills by opening the bottle, pouring a bunch out, and then leaving the lid off with extra still on the counter after he's done. You know, like a trained physician would.
Where's your wife, Professor?
She's no concern of yours.
Just leave me be behind this rock with my weird lion statue.
Something here through the arches to your left?
Yep, even through a communicator, a you need to come take a look at this cliche is still a you need to come take a look at this cliche. Kind of amazing with all this danger, people getting killed everywhere, that these two most important members of the Starship Enterprise are down here all alone.
Set your phaser on one quarter, I'll leave mine on stun.
One quarter of what? Only one quarter of him will die?
And he, or rather, it followed me.
It follows.
Crater!
This works. 1960s TV props at their finest. These stones would make Ed Wood proud.
Your wife, Professor, where is she?
She was the last of her kind.
Really? Still playing the pronoun game at this juncture instead of just saying what's killing all the crewmen?
Could offer it salt without tricks. There's no reason for it to attack us.
Despite this being self-preservation from fake McCoy here, it's a valid point. Why would this creature kill if Dr. Crater was feeding it salt this whole time? Why wouldn't the creature just ask for some salt instead of creeping around and trying to Weinstein the entire crew?
It needs love as much as it needs salt.
That seems like a scientific theory that would be easy to prove. Also...
This thing becomes wife, lover, best friend, wise man, fool, idol, slave.
But mainly what I want to know is what sex is like with it.
Fortunately, my ancestors spawned in another ocean than yours did. My blood salts are quite different.
And let's not forget how convenient it was when the salt creature's species was dying out. Two people with access to salt shipments came down to the planet to work for some reason that is never explained.
It's killing the captain! Shoot it, Doctor, quickly!
No!
Deus ex machina! Two-fisted air! Punching! So the show is telling us that this is what the creature actually looks like, and that somehow Dr. McCoy broke the spell, right? And since Crater insinuated that he and the creature had relations, I just have to point out that this is the actual mouth that would have been kissing him as well as engaging in other mouth-related activities. And I'm not sure how any of that would work without ending in tragedy. That look is the realization that Bones almost booned her. This episode does not contain a Scotty, and I want to forgive it, but I'm giving her all she's got and I just can't do it, Captain.
I see that red, I just want to go after it like a bull, you know?
Hello.
Hello!
That means that somebody is dead and you just sit there. It could be Captain Kirk. He's the closest thing you have to a friend.
Look at me, sure. Look at me, sure. I'm the captain now.
Our crewman died of salt depletion.
And by coincidence, both you and Mrs. Crater requested salt tablets.
The salt amount has to be just right, so the best fat for doing so comes from humans.
Hello, Beauregard. How are you today?
Feed me now!
There is no difference.
There's one, Professor. Your creature is killing my people.